Actually, the first group of discalced Carmelite missionaries arrived here in the Philippines in 1947. And ito po ay puro mga Amerikanong unang dumating.
Uh-oh.
And they proceeded to the prelature of Infanta.
Ah,
so
okay.
To the remote islands of Infanta, ito po ang pinili nila mga places, no? Sabi nilang malayong-malayo, yun ang hiningi nilang lugar. No? So, the thrust of the first missionaries in the Quezon province were threefold. Una, ang kanilang pinakaunang mission doon, kasi di ba, it's after the war. No? Ilang katatapos lang ng gera noon. So, ang kanilang mission doon, construction, Catholic action, and the third is education. Itong unang grupo ng mga American Carmelites were followed by Italians and Irish. So, tatlong provinces ang nag-merge doon, no, for the mission activities in the prelature. All in all, mga 38 po sila lahat during the time. So, ang unang obispo po ng prelature was Bishop Shanley. And after Bishop Shanley, no, ang pinakaunang Filipino bishop doon, si Bishop Julio Labayan. Pag-retire niya po, he was replaced by another Carmelite bishop, Bishop Rolly Tria Terona, now the Archbishop of Nueva Cáceres in Bicol. Same year, no? The Haro Foundation in Iloilo was established by the Irish Carmelites, the Mount Carmel Shrine, no? Now the Minor Basilica of the National Shrine of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. The foundation was also in 1953. No, and then the third foundation was in Bago City Negros Occidental in 1958, Spirituality Center. Ito po aming retreat house, no? Center of Spirituality sa Discalced Carmelites. So the fourth foundation that we have was in Davao City Monastery of the Holy Family. This is our novitiate. Then the fifth, the Saint John of the Cross, not just at the back of Our Lady Mount Carmel Shrine Parish Basilica. It was established in 1977. New foundation in Vietnam, our aspirancy house in Ho Chi Minh City in 2016. Mm-hmm. So, the province, the Carmelite province of St. Teresa here in the Philippines, no, five foundations here in the Philippines and one in Vietnam. So we only have six houses within the province. Our basic understanding of the mission of the order. Now, as Carmelites, prayer is the very essence of our existence in the church. Uh-oh. No? Yung pinakasentro ng buhay natin bilang mga Carmelites. How to preserve and promote more and more the spirit of prayer in the church. And also to invite more and more people and guide them, no, to make prayer also alive in their lives. Uh-huh. No? Kikita ang bunga ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. And even how it affects our community life, our relationship with our brothers and with people outside, and to the people we minister outside, no, at the same time. So, that is why it's also a breakthrough in the church when Saint Teresa was declared the first woman doctor of the church in 1970. 20, no? Kasi before, di ba, puro lalaki lang doctor of the church. Kaya nga, our other theologians would call her doctor of prayer. How she influenced no, the importance of prayer in the church. And she had this beautiful description of prayer, no? For Saint Teresa of Jesus, prayer is nothing else but a heart-to-heart conversation with the one whom we know loves us, no? For Saint Teresa of Jesus, prayer is friendship with God. Na bawat isa po, no? Not just for us religious, but anyone who wants to establish that friendship with God can make it happen. As long as we are humble and open enough to see the movements of God in our lives and how we respond to it. Malalaman natin at saka talagang sinuseryoso natin if we are also faithful to our prayer life. Not just our personal prayer life, but at the same time, our communal prayers. No? Kaya naka-highlight it sa about 2 minutes lagi, no? Ang prayer, no? Maraming prayer a day. From the rising of the sun to its setting, no? Pray 7 times a day, no? Wherever we are. So we have to find time. If we're outside the community, we have to find time, no? And so we are also called to be more open and more available to serve God's people, no? And more sensitive, especially during this time, no? This current situations. We're in the midst of pandemic, no? We are called to be more and more flexible, even in doing our apostolates, no? But being faithful to our life, no? As Carmelites. So